Sana pangalagaan sila. Sana maibalik sila ng buhay. Sana maibalik sila ng kanilang, sa kanilang mga pamilya. Sana matapos na ito. Sana we can just go back and rebuild our lives.
This was Bishop Edwin de la Peña's prayer Tuesday morning, May 30, as he awaits of news, any news about Father Teresito Suganob, his right-hand man and friend who was taken by the Maute group the night the clashes started.
Hoping against hope, no? Wait and waiting, no? Hanggang sa ngayon, no?
But no calls.
No calls. And this is the eighth day.
His heart sinks each time he hears the airstrikes. He keeps imagining, what if Father Chito is caught in the crossfire?
Natatakot ako sa kanila dahil wala namang pinipili yan eh. Yung mga targets nila is guesswork lang nila yun eh.
He says it is in the interest of the local terrorist groups to keep Father Chito alive. He's afraid Father Chito might end up as collateral damage.
Up to the last minute, nakailanganin nila yung kanilang na magagamit nila sila as human shield. Sa tindi ng operation ng military, I doubt it. Ang amin lang talagang pag-asa ay magkaroon ng milagro.
Just hours later, Father Chito appears in a propaganda video that spreads online. He vocalizes the demands of the local terrorists. It's hard to reconcile the man in the video and the priest the bishop described. In the video, believed to be put together by the terrorist, he supposedly supports the territorial bid of terrorist groups responsible for unthinkable crimes against the believers of his own religion. In the bishop's descriptions, he is a jolly man who dedicated his life to promote dialogue between Christians and Muslims.
Very jolly siya. And the life of the party, no? Tawag niya sa kanya is Chitrix Brown, no? Sa kanyang mga classmates sa seminary, sa mga pari dito sa Iligan. Siya yung palaging kinukuha na MC dahil magaling magpatawa.
The bishop welcomes the news that Father Chito is alive. But he says he's obviously under duress from the Maute group.
When you are held captive, you're not free to speak your mind. No, I hope the netizens would consider that, that he is under duress.
Yes, Bishop.
Forced to say things he normally would not say.
His scenario has come true. A very old trick that we also saw in the 2013 Zamboanga siege. Pinned down, the terrorist groups turned the priest into a human shield. Day 8 of the crisis throws a curveball. Terrorists never really play fair. Carmela Fonbuena Rappler, Iligan City.